Caring for others' feelings, others' ideas is also important. And respect for others' manners, that is basically manners. And law abiding, to obey the law is also one of the ethical value. So whatever laws we are to follow, we should follow that strictly. Commitment to excellence. And I always say, this I came across from Google founder, saying that excellence is exempted for reasonable delivery to larger section of society. That's what Google is doing today. We all see, I don't see anybody not using Google Maps or Google Search now. So that is his motto actually. He may not give 100% accurate information, but it gives the reasonable accurate information. So engineers are also expected to do reasonable delivery to the larger section of the society. Leadership, this is one biggest challenge for engineers. We lack, I have a book, Forks in the Road, written by a consultant engineer in California, who says that if engineers have leadership and managerial abilities, we rule the world. We have everything except leadership and management, because we are technically savvy. Next is the reputation and morale. Reputation of a person is very important because if he has ethical values and morale, and accountability. You should be accountable to what we are doing. Now, end of this, I want to tell you something. I have come across one intellectual saying that you write 10 best qualities you know about a person and think, check how many of them you have. He says that if anybody has 2 qualities, he's a great person out of 10. And he says, don't try to add that other 8 qualities which you don't have. Try to strengthen the 2 qualities which you have. That is, lifetime is enough. Life is not enough to add any new quality which you don't have naturally. So Mahatma Gandhi did that exactly. He has just strengthened the truth and non-violence, and he brought us the independence. So others, he has so many bad qualities, we know, but these good qualities strengthening has shadowed the other bad qualities which he had. So like that, every person can, I told 12 qualities of ethical values, but we need not try to imbibe all those 12 qualities, but at least have some of them, implement them in strict. Next is the professional issues. As I told, we have industry bodies. We have FICCI, we know, and CII, public sector companies, and we have NASCOM for in IT, academics and research, skill development and finishing school, technology, indigenization, construction, infrastructure, real estate and hospitality, design engineering. For this, we need institution of engineers like bodies to strengthen our qualities, impart training to the budding engineers, and encapsulate all the bodies. This is what I wish I could see in my lifetime, that there are so many associations. If you go to any district or any town, there is an association of engineers, and there are 250 members like that. In Tamil Nadu alone, there are 70 associations in the state of Tamil Nadu. And Telangana, we have all the 20 districts, we have 20 associations. So we should bring them together to handle our professional issues and impart this training. Employment and employability, this is what professional societies, more than 1,000 societies we have, but they are not connected. Safety in built environment, sustainability of resources, accountability of engineers, and public infrastructure maintenance and standards. These are the professional issues we are facing actually as engineers. Interdisciplinary issues also we have in our country. Architects think they are leading the built environment, and engineers to be subordinates. And engineers want to lead because 80% of the project is controlled by engineers. Civil engineer versus structural engineer. This is another, civil engineer means the one who is handling construction, and the structural engineer is the one who is giving the drawings. There are issues. And the structural engineer versus geotechnical engineer. Structural engineer, you ask a structural engineer, can you design the foundation? He will immediately ask you, what is the safe bearing capacity? So he doesn't need a geotechnical report. If you give safe bearing capacity, he will fix the footing size. So this is the nature of our structural engineers. And the civil engineers versus plumbing and sanitary. Civil engineers think they can do plumbing and sanitary. They don't need a plumbing expert. Civil engineer versus electrical engineer. Civil engineer versus air conditioning. So these are the things. In fact, I also try to bypass these trades. And even geology is very important. And environmental engineering is very important. Like that, we have so many interdisciplinary clashes and we have to resolve this. And you know, to our surprise, we have 30 million engineers in our country. And every year we are producing 1.6 million engineers, new engineers every year. So now you tell me, is it not a challenge to make these engineers ethical and to create healthy working atmosphere and healthy competition and create opportunities by mandatory professional compliance? So RERA is one such thing actually, but still we have to educate the industry to engage engineers for engineering. Save resources and energy. Engineers can do this. Reduce wastage by making engineers accountable. So engineers have to take the responsibility for minimizing the waste. Spend on technology upgrade. And we have so many schemes. Make in India, Swachh Bharat, Skill India, Startup India. For all this, we need good engineers. And engineers should lead this. And housing for all is another thing which we are working. And approve apex body, Institution of Engineers India or Indian Council of Engineers. This is in the draft proposal to regulate the industry needs of professional engineers. Only professional engineers can be made accountable. Regulate the division of skills in balanced approach, continuing professional development. And we are seeing today, Hyderabad has got at least 5 lakh engineers in the city, and we have not even 0.1% of them here. So this is the state of continuing professional development. And conserve material resources and energy by using effective human resource, that is engineers. We have 3 million engineers, which no other, many countries don't have population of 30 million. Leave alone engineers. So we lead in technology and technical manpower. Spend on disaster prevention and reduction rather than disaster management. So this engineers can do. And encourage innovation for Indian needs. This is one big thing I find. If anybody is here from Green Building Congress, IGBC, I have a question to them. This I asked in Patna also in our Institution of Engineers last year, that why do we adopt USGBC or LEED rating in India? India is totally a different country. We have to innovate for our needs, this green rating also. And affordable housing is a big need for our country. In fact, Abdul Kalam asked us engineers in one of the conference, that why engineers can't give a house for 1 lakh rupees. This is about 11 years back. He asked this, or 14 years back, yeah. Urban infrastructure, traffic management, flood management, manufacturing effectively. So these are the things. And these are all the projects. Okay, we talked about what engineers are to be, and now we are seeing what engineers made in our country. So it's not that we are all bad. We have great engineers, as we have seen. We have 18 endowment lectures in Hyderabad alone for AP and Telangana. So we have so many great engineers in our country. We still have to make more great engineers to make every project like this. And we have in Hyderabad now metro, Hyderabad metro made by engineers, great contribution. We have best airport in our country, Hyderabad airport. So like that, we have done 70,000 kilometers of highways in 4 years, golden quadrilateral, most effective and most durably we have done. And power plants and underground tunnels in Delhi. The tunnel is done in Delhi only, not in abroad. And we have done the ceiling bridge, Bombay, Bandra Varli ceiling bridge, mass housing, irrigation projects. I mean, Kaleswaram is one of the best example of dedicated engineers. And we have housing, two-bedroom housing, which is conceptualized, conceived in Hyderabad with the lowest cost possible. So these are all the things, but still the challenges that we have for professionals is unity among engineers. We have seen that the interprofessional integrity is another challenge. Leadership is the third challenge. Managerial ability is public trust. How many people trust our engineers? I, at least as a civil engineer, I see a mason is more trusted than an engineer. This is an unfortunate thing which we have to change. And the reason for that is professional ethics. I have seen my clients saying engineers steal, not S-T-E-E-L, he says S-T-E-A-L. So we have to counter this, we have to change this. I see at least 80% of people working in the department more dedicated and committed to the engineering. So we provide all these services as introduction. So I have talked so much, you may think, what is this man doing? So these are all the projects which we have done, which you have designed, which you have conceptualized, which you have delivered. I will not go into the detail, that is not the theme of the talk today, but I thought I must show what we have done in terms of design, and we have got the accolades from many clients, we have got the certification from the clients for doing these projects. We are involved in master planning, design, costing, delivery, timely planning, and procurement is another big challenge which we handled. We drafted the procurement norms deviating from the standard department to ensure that project is delivered on time at the cost which is envisaged. So these are all the projects we have completed, at least projects worth 10,000 crores in the last 25 years. And we are right now handling projects worth 3,000 crores on hand. So this is our background, and we try to improve. We are working. Some of my colleagues are here also today. On my request, I ask them, I may not get this opportunity to talk the same subject to them. So I requested them to be here. So these are all the projects. And please wait for the last slide. I have important slide at the end. So these are all the buildings, the infrastructure, and institutional, office, commercial buildings, residential, affordable housing, and townships, convention centers, and these are all the category educational institutions, and Secretariat of Andhra Pradesh we have done. And this topic I am inspired to talk today before you because I was part of an expert committee in Andhra Pradesh. Recently, for 4 months, we reviewed about 1 lakh crore worth projects, interacted with almost all the departments and got the inputs where we found that engineers are not using their might in the projects. This is my one sentence statement: for engineers to be better. And these are all the interiors projects also which we have done. Hotels, hospitality, hospitals, and institutions, and all this. So, almost last. Of course, this is completed projects. So this is my slogan for today, that is, we need not be disheartened with what we are or what is many people. We can arise, awake, and stop not. All the goal is reached, till all the goal is reached. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity, sir, and thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.